In this video, I'll demonstrate how to create objects in perspective, a feature introduced in CorelDRAW 2021. I can choose from 1, 2, or 3-point perspective and draw directly in the plane I want without needing to set up complex grids in advance. I can also place existing orthographic objects onto a perspective plane. Before we get started, if you're watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on Corel's Discovery Center. Here you can also view a written copy of this tutorial. I'll start with an introduction to perspective views. One-point perspective, with its single vanishing point, can be used to simulate a view along a road in which everything shrinks toward a point in the distance. Two-point perspective can be used to show a view from a corner, such as in this example of buildings that each shrink toward vanishing points off to the side. Two-point perspective can also be used to showcase a packaging design. Three-point perspective is generally used for more dramatic views that focus on the top of an object that vanishes toward the bottom, or vice versa, to show how objects look from below. These four objects demonstrate the four types of perspective drawing: one-point, two-point, and two versions of three-point perspective, bird's eye view and worm's eye view. Perspective objects are in their own groups, and multiple different perspective groups can exist in the same document. When a perspective group is selected, the Edit button appears at the top left, and the Edit Perspective Group option is also available in the object's context menu. Editing displays the perspective field, which can be selected and enlarged as needed, to display the horizon line and both vanishing points of this two-point perspective object. Now let's see how to create drawings in perspective. There are two workflows you can use: drawing objects from scratch in perspective, and moving existing objects onto perspective planes. I'll start with the second method, moving objects onto planes. In this example, I have the familiar three rectangles used to build the perspective cubes from the previous example. Each rectangle is part of a group, which also contains the objects inside the rectangle. When moving objects onto a perspective plane, it's much easier to work with a single group than with separate individual objects. I'll choose Object, Perspective, Draw in Perspective, and from the perspective options, I'll choose One Point. Now I can drag to place the perspective field, or I could press Enter to fill the entire page. I can move the vanishing point, raise or lower the horizon line, and adjust the density of perspective lines. The interactive property bar also contains options to toggle on and off the horizon line and perspective lines, change their colors, or adjust their opacity. Camera lines are off by default, but can be turned on, and the perspective field can be locked to prevent any accidental changes. I'll also make sure that snaps are enabled for objects, and I can also turn on snaps for perspective lines. The yellow group will be the front of the cube and will remain in the orthographic plane. All perspective objects need to be moved to a perspective plane, so I'll right-click on it and choose Move to Plane, Move to Orthographic Plane. With this object selected, I'll move it into the perspective field below the horizon line. The pink group will become the side of the cube, so I'll right-click on it and choose Move to Plane, Move to Side Plane. The perspective lines now follow the side plane, and when moving this object, its edges follow the perspective lines. I'll grab the lower front corner and line up this corner with the yellow front face. The side object is a bit too large, so I'll scale it uniformly inward from the opposite corner. The blue group will go on top, so I'll move it to that plane. After moving the object and connecting the corner node, I can use the side handles to resize in two directions. Selecting an object on a perspective plane activates that plane and its perspective lines, so it's easy to make the side face a bit shallower, which then means the top face also needs to be resized. When all looks good, I'll click Finish. This entire cube is now its own perspective group, comprised of the three original square objects. When selected, I can click the Edit button to return to editing in perspective. A perspective group can be moved or scaled uniformly, but other tools are grayed out, such as Rotate and Mirror. This is because those tools would break the relationships between objects on different planes. Finally, if I wanted to manipulate the various objects inside the perspective group, I'd first have to break apart the perspective group, then ungroup. Next, I'll show how to draw directly in perspective. In a blank document, I'll choose Object, Perspective, Draw in Perspective, and choose 2-point. I'll press Enter for a full-page perspective field, raise the horizon line, and increase the field density. To start drawing on the right side, I'll click the right icon. This changes the perspective lines to match the right plane. Now with the rectangle tool, I'll draw the right side of the box. The next rectangle will be along the left. I can snap to one corner and adjust the other edge to fit. Finally, I'll add the top rectangle, and in this plane, I can snap to both corners. For simple vector objects, such as a rectangle, ellipse, or a star, I can first activate the plane, then draw directly in perspective. Or I can switch to the orthographic plane to draw the star, and move the star to the plane where I want it. Then I can move it into place. But for more complex objects, it's usually better to work in orthographic view. So with the left side selected, I'll move it to the orthographic plane. Now I can add what I want, such as text or a logo or a common shape. In this example, the ellipse was added directly to the perspective group because it's a simple shape. The banner, logo, and text were added outside the perspective group. Any objects outside the perspective group must be added to one of the planes. So with these three objects selected, I'll move them to the orthographic plane to match the rectangle on which they're placed. Now these objects are inside the perspective group. So that the entire side of the box will act as one object, I'll add the rectangle and ellipse to what is selected and group all objects. Now I can move this entire group to the left plane. After clicking Finish to end perspective editing, everything on all sides of the box is in the correct location and orientation. Finally, sometimes you may have to combine perspective drawing with regular 2D drawing to get the look you want. In this example, I have two sides of a carton in perspective, and I want to add the triangular top. I can start the top part by drawing a rectangle across the middle of the box while in the right plane. I'll resize to push this rectangle up a bit, so that what remains will be the very top of the carton. Now I'll switch to the orthographic plane and use the pen tool to create this four-sided shape. I'll use the same tool for this small triangle in the back. These two closed shapes aren't exactly perspective objects, but because they are associated with a plane, they remain inside the perspective group. I can add more objects to these new faces using CorelDRAW's rotating and skewing tools to simulate the perspective look. This brings us to the end of this tutorial on drawing in perspective in CorelDRAW. If you've been watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on Corel's Discovery Center. Here you can also view a written copy of this tutorial.